Hello, I'm Mithali Singh and I'm currently working as a legal intern at Lexis & Company. And in this video, I'm gonna deal with the remaining topic that is who may give an adoption. In my previous video, I discussed about the topic that is adoption and the first part of the adoption that is who may take an adoption. And in this video, I'm gonna talk about who may give an adoption, which means that कौन कौन अडॉप्शन में चाइल्ड को दे सकता है. सो टू हैव अ बेटर पिक्चर ऑफ दिस टॉपिक आई हैव डिवाइडेड माई टॉपिक्स इन टू फ्यू पार्ट्स. फर्स्ट पार्ट इज दैट द अर्लियर पार्ट ऑफ द हु मे गिव एन अडॉप्शन. दैट मीन्स दैट अर्लियर हु वॉज केपेबल इनफ टू गिव अ चाइल्ड एन अडॉप्शन. सो इफ आई टॉक अबाउट बिफोर द कमेंसमेंट if I talk about the period before the commencement of Hindu Adoption Maintenance Act, only the natural mother and the father of a child had the capacity to give their child an adoption. No guardian, nothing were capable enough to give a child an adoption. Only the mother and the father had the capacity to give a child an adoption. But if I talk about the recent scenario or after the commencement of Hindu Adoption Maintenance Act, the Hindu Adoption Maintenance Act came into force and gave the capacity to a guardian also, apart from the mother and father of the child. Now the guardian also has a capacity to give a child an adoption. Secondly, I will be dealing with the capacity of the father, mother and the guardian to give a child an adoption. So basically section 9 of the Hindu Adoption Maintenance Act deals with the capacity of the father, mother and the guardian to give a child an adoption. And now I'm gonna talk about the first part, or we can say that the clause 1 of the section 9, which gives the capacity to the Hindu father to give a child an adoption. So if I talk about the capacity of a father here, the definition of the father includes only the natural father of a child, neither the adopted father nor the stepfather. Only the natural father of a child has a capacity to give a child an adoption. And in order to give a child an adoption, the consent of the mother of the child is very much necessary. If the consent of the mother of a child is not being obtained by the father, then such adoption will stand void. But in few cases, the consent of the mother of a child is not necessary, and such cases are if the mother has ceased to be a Hindu, second, if the mother has completely and finally renounced the world, third, if the mother is being declared as a person of unsound mind by a competent court. In these three conditions, if any of these three conditions are fulfilled, then the consent of the mother of a child is not necessary. Otherwise, the consent of a mother of a child is necessary in order to give a child an adoption. Now, the second part of the section 9 deals with the capacity of a Hindu mother to give a child an adoption. So, I told you about the capacity of a Hindu father to give a child an adoption. Now, I'm going to talk about the capacity of a Hindu mother to give a child an adoption. And clause 2 of section 9 talks about the capacity of a Hindu mother to give a child an adoption. Earlier, the Hindu mother had no capacity to give a child an adoption, but after the commencement of Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act, this bar has been lifted up, and the capacity or the right to give a child an adoption was given to Hindu mothers also. Now, in modern Hindu law, or after the commencement of Hindu Adoption Maintenance Act, now Hindu mother also has the same capacity as that of the Hindu father to give her child an adoption, but only after obtaining the consent of the father of a child. If the consent of the father of a child is not obtained, then such adoption would be considered as a void adoption, and which would be considered as an invalid one. But there are cases, or we can say that there are circumstances under which the consent of the father is not necessary, and such circumstances are, first, if the father has ceased to be a Hindu, Second, if the father has been declared as a person of an unsound mind by a competent court. And third, if the father is not alive or if the father has completely or finally renounced the world. Under these circumstances, the consent of the father of a child is not necessary to give a child an adoption. In such cases, the Hindu mother has an absolute right to give her child an adoption. And if I talk about after the death of the father of a child, then in this case also, the Hindu mother has a full capacity to give a child an adoption after the death of the father. Then the consent is not necessary. जब father की death ही हो गई है तो consent तो matter ही नहीं करता. तो इस केस में जो हिंदू फीमेल है उसके पास फुल कैपेसिटी होती है कि वो अपने चाइल्ड को अडॉप्शन में दे सकते हैं. इवन दो अगर एट द टाइम ऑफ द लिविंग ऑफ द फादर डिनाइड गिविंग हिज कंसेंट फॉर गिविंग अ चाइल्ड इन अडॉप्शन, अगर उसने मना भी करा था अपने मतलब इन हिज लाइफ स्पैन, अगर उसने मना भी करा था कि उसके मरने के बाद भी उसके चाइल्ड को अडॉप्शन में मत देना, तो ये चीज़ मैटर नहीं करेगी. अगर फादर की डेथ हो गई है तो उसके बाद मदर के पास एब्सोल्यूट राइट होता है, एब्सोल्यूट कैपेसिटी होती है कि वो अपने चाइल्ड को अडॉप्शन में दे सकती है, उसको किसी कंसेंट की नीड नहीं होती. नाउ वी जंप ऑन टू द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ द सेक्शन 9 विच डील्स विद द कैपेसिटी ऑफ अ गार्जियन टू गिव अ चाइल्ड इन द अडॉप्शन. अर्लियर एज आई टोल्ड यू दैट ओनली द हिंदू मदर एंड द फादर हैड द कैपेसिटी टू गिव अ चाइल्ड इन अडॉप्शन. But after the commencement of Hindu Adoption and Maintenance Act, or we can say that under the modern Hindu law, the guardians were also given the capacity to give a child in adoption. अब आप बोलोगे कि गार्जियन की डेफिनेशन क्या है, एग्जैक्ट डेफिनेशन. तो एग्जैक्ट डेफिनेशन हम गार्जियन को ये बोल सकते हैं दैट अंडर द हिंदू अडॉप्शन मेंटेनेंस एक्ट, बेसिकली गार्जियन कैन बी डी फैक्टो गार्जियन ऑल्सो एंड डी ज्यूरी गार्जियन ऑल्सो. गार्जियन कैन बी अ मैनेजर ऑफ ऑर्फनेज ऑल्सो. गार्जियन कैन ईदर बी अ पर्सन हु हैज ब्रॉट अप अ चाइल्ड एंड अंडर हुज केयर द चाइल्ड इज. ये तीनों ही केसेस में हम उसको उस पर्सन को हम गार्जियन बोलेंगे. एंड सच गार्जियन वुड बी हैविंग द कैपेसिटी और वुड बी हैविंग द राइट टू गिव अ चाइल्ड इन द अडॉप्शन. सो आई वुड लाइक टू से दैट द टॉपिक ऑफ द गार्जियन इज वेरी वाइड. फॉर दिस वीडियो आई एम गोना एंड दिस टॉपिक हियर. एंड इन माई नेक्स्ट वीडियो आई एम गोना डील विद द who the exact definition of guardian and what are the powers of guardian and what are the rights of the guardian and in which cases the guardian has no capacity to give a child an adoption. So I'm going to deal with all these topics in my next video. Till then, take care, and that's it for this video. I hope I was able to deliver or I was able to cover up all the topics related to the topic, that is who may give an adoption.